By 1925, groups of Smyrna musicians with their santuris and ouds were beginning to emerge in Athens, in cabarets known as Café Aman. These cafes were more respectable than the underworld haunts of the Rebetis. They attracted singers like Rosa Eskenazi, a famous star in Turkey before the Smyrna catastrophe. Ironically, it was the Smyrna-style groups that popularized Rebetika. They began to include Rebetika songs in their repertoires, giving this music a sort of respectability. Within 5 years, Athenians were listening to the hashish songs of Piraeus, songs about Crazy Nick and Marinos, the mustache. A Crazy Nick was a convicted killer. He was also one of the most colorful figures of the Piraeus underworld, complete with his Italian hats, two-tone shoes, and personal bodyguards. The record companies were quick to capitalize on the growing taste for underworld music. They discovered the man who is now thought of as the father of Rebetika, Marcos Van Bacaris. Marcos was 20 years old before he showed any interest in Rebetika. But by the time he was 25, he was about to begin a recording career that made him one of the most famous performers in Greece. Marcos was still recording when he died. Thousands of Rebetika fans attended the funeral. His beloved bouzouki provided the final farewell. Shortly before Marcos died, he made a rare appearance on film. Listening to Marcos, it's easy to understand why many people compare Rebetika to the blues of black America. Rebetika and the blues were both expressions of minority groups that found themselves on the outskirts of respectable society. Their music reflected the harshness and the pain of living on the outside. For the legendary blues singer Bessie Smith, the songs were a mirror of her own tragic life.
My man's got a heart like a rocket in the sea. My man's got a heart like a rocket in the sea.